Sheriff's deputy shot during a violent police chase is breathing a bit easier tonight. The county has made an unprecedented decision to make sure she keeps getting the benefits she had while on duty. Action 7 News reporter Laura Terrain joins us live outside the Bernalillo County Sheriff's Office with those details.
Right now, Deputy Hopkins is on administrative leave, which means she continues to get her retirement benefits and her family can stay on her health insurance. But right now, Deputy Hopkins' situation is the exception, and Bernalillo County wants to change the rule. It reads Honor and Courage on Bernalillo County Sheriff's vehicles, and many say Deputy Robin Hopkins displayed exactly that when she was shot trying to stop Christopher Chase in his violent rampage.
She did nothing wrong. There was no negligence on her part. She was shot with a military assault rifle.
But something was wrong. About a month into Hopkins' recovery, the president of the Bernalillo County Sheriff's Association learned Hopkins was no longer receiving retirement benefits and her family's health insurance was running out.
She has a husband and a one-year-old son. Their health insurance would stop.
So the county placed Hopkins on administrative leave to keep her benefits rolling in. And now the county manager is drafting new policy to protect deputies and other first responders injured in the future.
If there's some act of violence like that specific towards first responders, this kind of more than, you know, this 100% coverage has to kick in.
So you might be asking yourself, why wasn't this kind of policy implemented years ago? Well, a spokesperson for Bernalillo County tells me it's because this sort of incident has never happened before.
This situation is a new one. And it's very hard to have policy for every situation that comes up.
As for Deputy Hopkins, we're told she's moving with a walker and bravely pushing to get back on the job she loves.
If determination and will means anything, she'll be back soon.
Now, in drafting this new policy, the county will have to decide which cases are eligible for full protection and which aren't. For example, a deputy who is injured intentionally by someone on the job might be eligible for the full protection, but someone who's hurt in another way could not. Live in downtown Albuquerque, Laura Terrain, KOAT Action 7 News.
The county commission will likely vote on a new policy next month. Sheriff Dan Houston tells Action 7 News he hopes it goes through.